On behalf of the Cuyahoga Heights Local School District, representing the villages of Cuyahoga Heights, Brooklyn Heights, Valley View, and our tuition community, it is my distinct honor to welcome you to the 84th commencement ceremony of Cuyahoga Heights High School, and to celebrate the class of 2022. My name is Mike Janatovich, and it has been my privilege to serve as principal of Cuyahoga Heights High School. On behalf of the entire faculty and staff of Cuyahoga Heights High School, welcome to our celebration. At this time, I would like to acknowledge our Board of Education, district level administration, and village leadership. Board President, Mark Dobbins. Board Vice President, Mrs. Maria Etter. Board Member, Mrs. Stephanie Prowse. Board Member, Ms. Lindy Schubert. Board Member, Mr. Gary Suchaki. Superintendent, Mr. Tom Evans. Treasurer, Mr. Matt Muccio. Assistant Superintendent, Mr. Matt Young. Mayor Jack Bocci. Mayor Jerry Piasecki. And Mayor Mike Prozek. Please give them a round of applause for their support of our students. In addition to our district administration and board members, I am indebted to Mr. George Burek, who serves as assistant principal and pupil services director, Mrs. Joy Houchin, our elementary school principal, Mr. Ryan Kelber, our athletic director, to our school counselors, Mrs. Holly Brasher and Mrs. Audrey Lorenz, and our secretaries, Mrs. Danielle Connors, Mrs. Chris Ludra, and Ms. Erin Zink, for their tireless efforts this year. Please join me in recognizing these individuals for their efforts today. I also want to give a huge thank you to our senior class advisors, Ms. Sheila Ogden and Mrs. Christine Bennett, who have worked diligently through the school year to arrange our senior events and to assure a memorable senior year. I'd like for both of them to stand up, and please give them a round of applause. Furthermore, Mr. Dave Wallace and his staff in the technology department, and to Mr. Jim Zerbola and the custodial staff, who have played an instrumental role in setting up today's ceremony. As you can tell by the beautiful layout of our ceremony being held outdoors, they work effortlessly on this, and let's give them a round of applause for their hard work. Thank you to each teacher and staff member in our wonderful school district who did his or her part to provide students with quality education in a supportive environment. If you are an employee of the district, please stand so you can be recognized for all that you have done for these students. All staff employees, school employees, please stand to be recognized. At this time, I would like to recognize the members of the class of 2022 who plan to join the military, as well as anyone present here today that is currently serving or has served our country. Your commitment to serve our country is certainly worthy of special recognition. Please stand and be recognized at this time. Parents, grandparents, and other family members, I would like to thank you for the support you have offered your students and this school. Students, please join me in thanking your families for their support. Our attention now turns to the class of 2022. Class of 2022, you define what it means to be resilient and adaptive. Throughout your 4 years of high school, you've had many challenges that were presented to you. That did not stop you. Your class rose to all occasions presented to it, and you did it with a smile on your face. You did it with kindness, you did it with excellence. The class of 2022 is a special class. You've excelled in the classroom, on the athletic field, on the stage. You've created wonderful things. You've performed many wonderful performances. You've done tremendous work in and out of the classroom, in the community, supporting the community, and other things that I have no clue, but I know happens on a daily basis with this class. You have taken initiatives to grow together as a class. You have stuck together, supported each other, and today we are here to celebrate your accomplishments as you prepare to be graduates from high school. Today is a special day. Today, we celebrate the earning of diploma from Cuyahoga Heights School District. Cuyahoga Heights is special. The three villages and the tuition families provide a supportive environment that has allowed you to experience many opportunities. Because of our supportive communities, you've had the opportunity to take educational risks and be involved in activities that you wouldn't think you would have a chance to be involved in. The opportunities that Cuyahoga Heights has provided you have made you a stronger person and has prepared you for the next phase of your life. Today, however, marks the beginning rather than the ending. The definition of commencement is simply a new beginning or start. Before we proceed with the ceremony, I want to leave you with words from a former Cuyahoga Heights student that I received last year as my first year principal here who wanted to remain anonymous. I read it last year and it really stuck with me, and I think it's also very important to share with this class. They shared with me, "Think back to everything you were able to achieve. Think back to everything you were able to experience. Think back to the support you have received. Think back to the love that has shown you. Think back to the amazing days in school that helped develop who you are." Short words, but I think they're very powerful. Thinking back is not just to remember the good. It is a way for you to persevere. You will be met with challenges in the next phase of your life. Life will get hard. Think back. Think back to what Cuyahoga Heights provided you. Think back to what you were able to accomplish. Think back to those that supported you and reach out to them, for they are always here. Cuyahoga Heights is special. Cuyahoga Heights is about people. You will always be remembered. You will always be supported. Think back, and it will allow you to accelerate forward. Congratulations to you, the class of 2022. You did it the right way. Please keep your alma mater in your hearts and minds as you go forward. And thank you for being a shining example of the Cuyahoga Heights tradition and pride. Remember often to think back. As we move forward now with our commencement proceedings, it is imperative that while we celebrate the graduation of your students, you hold your applause until everyone has received a diploma so that every family has the opportunity to hear their student's name announced clearly. Cell phones should be turned off during the ceremony. Also, please refrain from entering areas that may block the views of others so everyone can see the graduates receiving a diploma. Thank you. And at this time, I ask everyone to please stand as Riley Connors comes out to sing our national anthem.
pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all. Please be seated. I now like to introduce Mr. David Michaels and Ty Mitchell.
At this time, I would like to introduce your senior treasurer, Hannah Morrow, who will recognize the class of 2022.
Thank you, Mr. Dantone, for the introduction. I must admit, I was racking my brain on how I might adequately introduce the class of 2022. I mean, how does someone summarize 12 years of memories using just one speech? And honestly, what can I say about our class that you haven't already heard? I could stand up here and tell you that Dominic Belko basically invented three-pointers. Or that even with a torn ACL, Regan Sturgill is still a better soccer player than anyone in the stadium. I could mention that Holden Taylor is a certified genius and that Lily Frank is the next Picasso. I could even explain that it would probably kill Pat Mischek to show up on class, show up on time to class. And that Nick Chudnowski might be Mick Jagger's long-lost son. But alas, these are all things that everybody already knows. But why do we know them? Well, living in such a small community, we have been conditioned to put everyone in their own little box. Regan, soccer star. Holden, the brains. We are defined by our strengths, and we are told who we should and shouldn't be. So we become the overachievers, the star athletes, the AP students, or maybe we can become the opposite, the excluded, the ones just scraping by. Whether it's the overachiever or the latter, we are faced with these external pressures that dictate who we are. We change ourselves to fit the mold that we are given, and ultimately, we have trouble becoming the people that we want to be. I'd like to take this time to share a quote from my favorite novel, The Awakening, that really speaks volumes to our class. On page 73, chapter 19, the author writes, "She was becoming herself and daily casting aside that fictitious self, which we assume like a garment with which to appear before the world." For those of you that are not familiar with The Awakening, the whole plot is centered around the main character breaking away from the societal implications that she is faced with and truly discovering her individuality. So with that being said, I urge the class of 2022 to take this box that we've been placed in our whole entire lives and punch a hole in it. We are not defined by the person that we've been conditioned to be. The person that you are in high school is not the person that you'll be forever. It is time to reject the impatience that we have been faced with, to discover individuality, and to take our lives into our own hands. Because let's face it, we've got one life to live, and it's completely ours. Thank you.
Good afternoon, everyone. Welcome to the 84th commencement exercise for Cuyahoga High Schools. To the class of 2022, congratulations. And as a graduate of the class of 1977, let me be the first one to welcome you to the Alumni Association. Salutatorian and valedictorian are determined by a combination of factors including GPA rank, ranking and ACT-SAT scores, and in the case of Cuyahoga's state achievement test. To the class of 2022, if you remember back to those first days of the school year when I talked about how you will create your own legacy, not me, not the teachers, not anyone else, but your actions will define your class. I will tell you, your legacy in my eyes will be that of a group that is resilient. Your spirit has not been diminished by the chaos that goes on around you. You have helped return a sense of normalcy to our district, keep that spirit, and continue to pay forward as you move beyond our doors and make your own paths. At this time, I'd like Tommy Wilson to come forward, please. The class salutatorian is Tommy Wilson. Tommy is the son of Lisa and Skip Wilson. The first item I want to address is referring to him as Tommy. You see in the program, he's listed as Thomas. The only time my mother ever called me Thomas was when she was mad at me. Please note, Tommy is a term of endearment. When I returned to Cuyahoga Heights in 2010, my teachers, Mr. Massey, Mr. Atwell, Mr. Durbin, Mrs. Elazny, were still around substituting, and it was Tommy, how are you? And I carry that pride with me. Tommy, it's an honor for me to present you today. Tommy Wilson graduates having completed 10 advanced placement courses and 3 college credit courses. Tommy has participated in every offering our music department has presented in 4 years. I mean every offering. Jazz band, orchestra, band, plays, if anything music, is Tommy Wilson. He sang some Scarlet Angels. Thanks, Tommy. He said, I got you, Tommy. He is a member of National Honor Society. To no surprise, Tommy will be attending Baltimore Orleans Music Conservatory in the fall to major in music education. Ladies and gentlemen, the salutatorian for the class of 2022, Tommy Wilson.
Thank you, Mr. Evans. Before I get anyone's hopes up, I am not a public speaker or a speech writer in any sense of the word, so bear with me, I'm doing my best. Also, I am very willing to take off this cap, so the castle does not keep flying in my head. In seventh grade, for those of us who are here, we did a project in social studies class called Jane Cafe, which was essentially just a research project that we did on a topic that we learned throughout that year. The year before, my sister Becca, hi Becca, who is in the audience, did the project and she told me to choose the religion of Taoism, since I would quote-unquote get respect since no one chooses it. So I chose Taoism, because why not? It was just a project that did. Grand project at the end of the year that I was trying to get out of the way, because who tries to get in the year after the CHS Class by the way, teachers? Since most people probably don't know the second teacher that I just missed, Taoism is an ancient Chinese religion developed by Lao Tzu in the 1st century BCE, centered around the belief that all living creatures should try and live in a state of harmony with the universe. But what most people do know about the symbol is, or about the religion, is the symbol of the yin yang. It's a cool black and white spiral that otherwise would make a cool tattoo. So everyone try and picture the yin yang. Close your eyes, blue beads, whatever, blank, I don't care. Now focus on like a black part of the swirl. That's called the yin, which represents the darkness in the universe. Now if you focus on a white swirl, you can guess it's called the yang, which represents all the light in the universe. Focus on the symbol as a whole. For those without a photographic memory, there's a black spot in the yang, the light, and there's a white spot in the yin, darkness. Which plainly means that where there's good, there's darkness within, where there's darkness, there's goodness within. Or more potentially, the intrinsic link between the dichotomous good and evil within our own consciousness. Now that we have refamiliarized ourselves with the yin yang, open your eyes and stop planking with you to that. Ever since that project, the yin yang has been in the back of my mind. My friends will know that when I'm doodling, it's not Squidward from SpongeBob that I make friends with a handlebar mustache and meaty baguette, then I would doodle a yin yang. But as commencement has approached, I've come to look at the world through more of a Taoist lens. And through that lens, may I present to you all in attendance the yin yangs in the class of 2022. Every young adult you see before you is a yin yang. Each person may have a little bit of mischief in their bones and probably farted as a kid and tried to blame it on someone else. But every one of these graduates has begged, pleaded, and struggled throughout the year like anyone else. And these graduates have also loved, laughed, and lived their best lives at a school that strives for the best of everyone. These graduates represent the dichotomy from before. Each one has suffered a word to live, and overcoming that adversity is a part of achieving harmony in the universe. And in this universe, as everyone knows, it is filled with darkness. But that doesn't mean there can't be love. Well, look at the sun. But don't actually call the sun, take it as an example. Without the sun, we wouldn't just live in darkness, we would also not be able to live without its light. So at this time, during our commencement, all the graduates behind me that I cannot see, we have achieved a great success. For all of us, whether it's been those like me who have been at the school since pre-K for 14 years, or even those who just joined in these past few, you are passing a milestone, a page turn in the story of your life, the end scene in the movie recounting your tale, another metaphor for a transition in your life. And next year, you'll be moving on to bigger and better things. After this milestone, again, you'll face times of darkness. That is just how it is. But it feels like the sun has stopped shining and there's no hope in sight. And I tell you that in these trying times, be the light in the darkness. You're the reason your life is worth living. Every person in this class and everyone in attendance is a beautiful human being, inside and out, objectively speaking, that is a fact. Raise other people, or use the darkness to make it brighter than when the sun shines before the darkness. Raise other people out of the darkness to spread the light. Make it contagious, spread it like a virus, no masks, no social distancing. It is necessary for our survival as a species. I'm a movie guy. I watched this movie once that ended by saying that the best way to end an essay was by quoting someone else. He said that someone has probably said it better than you've never put it, so that's how I'm ending my speech. I wasn't sure if I could have gone with easy quoting of Monty Python's Life of Ryan and just start singing Always Look on the Bright Side of Life, or invite the last one of my other sister, Sarah. Hi, Sarah. But it would have been good, no doubt, but I decided to go in a different direction. This past year, a movie came out called Everything Everywhere All at Once, which I saw with my other sister, Beth. Hi, Beth. Don't watch it, it's confusing. It's a brain bender. The only way to summarize it is that it's a multiverse movie for Doctor Strange. But anyway, in this movie, one of our protagonists, Raymond, is monologuing to different people trying to attack his wife since he jumped between multiverse. Again, confusing. Anyway. In this scene, what I'll leave with you today, Raymond summarizes everything I'm trying to say with that report. Please, can we just stop fighting? You tell me that it's a cruel world and we're all just running around in circles. I know that. I've been on this earth just as many days as you, and I know you're all fighting because you're scared and confused. I'm confused too. All day, I don't know what the heck is going on. Sometimes, or somehow, this feels like it's all my fault. But I choose to see the good side of things. I'm not being naive. It is strategic and necessary. It's how I've learned to survive through everything. I don't know. The only thing I do know is that we have to be kind. Please, be kind. Especially when we don't know what's going on. I know you see yourself as a fighter, but I see myself as one too. this is how I fight. Thank you and be kind.
I'd like to ask Holden Taylor to please come forward. Holden's loaded down with medals. I call that the Mr. T starter kit. Holden Taylor is a valedictorian for the class of 2022. He is the son of Corey Taylor and Dr. Kristen Lucas. Holden is the president of the class of 2022. He will graduate having completed 9 advanced placement classes, 4 college credit plus classes. Holden is also a national merit finalist and received the highest honor bestowed upon a scholar in receiving the Phi Beta Kappa Award winner for Cuyahoga High Schools. Holden has participated in track for 3 years, basketball for 4 years, serving as team captain this season. He has been a member of the band his entire middle and high school career and served as field commander this past year. He's also a member of the jazz band and has been selected as a member of the Chagrin Valley Conference Honors Band. And oh, by the way, he was homecoming king this year. Holden will attend Yale in the fall, majoring in environmental sciences with hopes of being a forester someday. Ladies and gentlemen, the valedictorian for the class of 2022, Holden Taylor.
Thank you. Hello, family and friends of the class of 2022. I'm so happy to be speaking to you, the valedictorian this year's class. I've been dreaming of this moment since I learned what a valedictorian was in the fourth grade. Fourth grade Holden, sitting in Mrs. Sweeney's class all the way over there, learning how to apply multiplication, what made me proud. I'll begin the speech with a little story, a story that comes at the expense of my dad. I apologize for that. In the summer of 2020, I was sitting around a fire with my brothers in Lane High. We were discussing how big the universe is and all the things we don't know. What is out there beyond the stars? How much of our world is undiscovered? Did people really touch and build every single inch of my house, of this school? Why do I cry? Am I the only conscious one, and are you all figments of my imagination? It was about this time when my dad decided to join us around the fire. We asked him his opinion on these ideas and his thoughts on how small we are in this universe. To which he responded, I don't really know. I don't really think about that stuff. When you get older, we get too busy to think about that. Completely fair, right? I'm sure many adults in this audience agree that this type of thinking kind of childish and even, you know, self-obsessive. You adults have to focus on much more important and urgent matters, such as the food on your dinner table that night, the bills you have to pay, your career, your relationship, the minion meme you have to post on Facebook. It's exhausting, I'm sure. You don't have time to deeply wonder, to lie in the grass and look up and consider all that is out there. Well, we children do. I find that this wonder that we possess while young isn't valued by many adults. We've all been told before to grow up, to stop being childish, be more like an older sibling. But I believe if we try our best to stay young and curious, we can carry this wonder with us as we grow. I love the environment, so I'll use a metaphor I came up with today. Though similar stories have been used in these teachings, I'm sure in other words. If I were to converse with a 500-year-old pine tree and a 2-year-old sapling, and I wanted to learn more about the earth, who should I ask? A 500-year-old pine tree? He stood tall and motionless for 500 years and watched over the world around it. With a 2-year-old sapling, who just 2 years ago was a pine cone in the mouth of a squirrel being given a tour of the forest, later dropping the pine cone into a creek, where the creek fed into a lake. This pine cone floated across the lake, listening to the songs of the birds, talking to the fish below it, until the pine cone reached the shore and decided to begin growing like the sapling. I personally would ask the sapling, for it is so much closer to the earth, and has so much more knowledge on where it's come from. I believe we ought to listen to children, those individuals who are left behind for not getting it, simply being too young. If we decided to dismiss this 2-year-old sapling because it needed to be this tall to ride, then think of all the incredible opinions we've missed on. Think of all the wonderful ideas that we disregarded. Now, I know this is a valedictorian, but I call upon you adults in this crowd. Listen to us. Listen to the next generation. After all, who is closer to the earth? Who is more curious and full of questions and willing to learn? Now, I'm not asking that we disregard every adult in the world, every 500-year-old pine tree, because of course, there is so much to be learned from the wisdom of those with experience. But
What did this forest look like 500 years ago? What have you experienced over this time? But please, don't disregard this apple. At this time, I'd like to ask every one of you to think of your favorite old person. As weird as that sounds, really think of your favorite old person. It could be a grandparent, a teacher, someone famous, anyone. Now, how stern and adult-like do they act? Are they a very serious and earnest and stone-faced person? Or are they more cheerful and joyous and playful? I think of Albert Einstein, his comment. I think of the Queen of England's weakness. I think of Stephen Hawking's witty remarks. And I think of my Nana's constant jokes and laughter. But people who have lived longer than all of us, who have seen and learned more than you can imagine, tend to be the most kid-like people we know. They get it. They understand. Don't take it from me. Take it from the wisest people we know. It pays to view the world through childlike eyes. And then, we each decide as we grow how much of that wonder and curiosity we will carry with us. Don't fall victim to the mundane. Don't fall victim to the mundane. I encourage each and every one of us graduating seniors to try our best not to grow up. We feel it is our responsibility to take on every demand of adulthood as soon as possible. With that, lose that childlike wonder we all once held. I ask that every one of you, as we move on from high school, stay young, remain curious, and please, don't grow up. Thank you.
Let's give another round of applause for the fine students that came up here to show them the things about. At this time, I would like for the senior choir members to join Ms. Trader as they perform one last time as a student at Cuyahoga Heights. And if you bear with us while we set up the microphones and the choir gets set up. Thank you. At this time, I would like to call up the senior orchestra members to join Mr. David Michaels and the orchestra as they play a piece for us. At this time, I would like to call up Alex Crocker, Senior Class Secretary, for our parents' recognition.
Another commencement tradition is the recognition of parents and mothers. Without you, this journey would not have been possible. As a small thank you, each senior will present a rose to you, symbolic to the unconditional love and support you have given us. Seniors, please present your roses to your families at this time.
Mr. Evans and the Cuyahoga Heights Board of Education members, it is my pleasure to present the class of 2022 for conferring of diplomas by the authority vested in my position by the State of Ohio and the Cuyahoga Heights Board of Education. I attest that those seated before you have completed all graduation requirements and are ready to receive their Cuyahoga Heights High School diploma. I ask that while names are being read and diplomas are being presented, that you hold your applause until Mrs. Bennett and Mrs. Thrasher have read the final names of our seniors. This will help us to ensure that all families have the opportunity to hear their student's name. Once again, please refrain from blocking views so that everyone can see the graduates receiving their diplomas. Thank you for your cooperation. At this time, it is my pleasure to introduce, once again, Superintendent at Cuyahoga High School, Mr. Tom Evans.
Mr. Janatovich, the superintendent, I hereby state to the Board of Education that the high school diploma requirements of each student conforms to the proper certification and notify you and all present of the acceptance of your recommendation. For the conferring of diplomas, I present board members Mr. Mark Dobbins, Vice President Mrs. Maria Etter, board members Stephanie Krause, Lenny Schubert, and Gary Suchaki. At this time, we will begin awarding the diplomas.
Holden Lucas Taylor. Thomas Richard Wilson. Carly Anna White. Alexandria Lynn Crocker. Anna Grace Morrow. Michaela Marie Adams. Madeline Lee Hamari. Jacob Anthony Martino. Alexis Nicole Baycheck. Zakaya Tierra Baker. Samuel Winston Vasconi. Dominic Paul Belko. Jacob Stephen Bernstein. Zachary Allen Bernstein. Ahmad Hezekiah Butler. Samantha Margaret Polaris. Caitlin Elise Calvi. Alana Marie Castro. Antonio Schifalo. Maya Elizabeth Daddario. Charles Joseph Dalton. Tiernan Zane DeFranco. Colin Donald Deca. Delaney Mora DeSanta. Andrew Paul Dombowski. Hope Dezer. Jacob Patrick Bobozo. Lily Marie Frank. Griffin Joseph Gross. Alyssa Deanne Jones. Mason Albert Jones. Nicholas Anthony Chuknowski. Savannah Marie Capus. Dustin Daniel Kaplan. Jack Christopher Clammer. Jersey Nicole Comar. Ryan Anthony Perjuicy. Madison Grace Krasnowick. Emmanuel Theodore Blazer. Jason Thomas Meatbone. Nathan Michael Menkoff. Nicholas John Myhall. Patrick James Mischuk. Angel Eli Oaxaca. Clara Jean Orman. Brady Michael Pinter. Paige Elizabeth Porter. Julia Rose Quinones. Joshua Thomas Sanahe. Olivia Alexis Santiago. Owen Michael Schubert. Jacob Raymond Seymour. Andon Jacob Sigmeyer. Alyssa Maria Sinira. Mia Marissa Spicer. Jacob Allen Stalker. Madison Justine Sucka.
Yeah!
Regan Marie Sturgill. Luke Anthony Torgerson.
Yeah!
Haley Tora Tope. Dominic Vincent Truso Lapanza. Alexander James Truso. Demetria Elena Sondin. Michael Craig Zork.
That is a well-deserved round of applause for the class of 2022. At this time, I would like to call up Holden Taylor and the senior class officers.
Cuyahoga. Please join me in the moment we've all been waiting for, the turning of the tassel. Let this symbolize the beginning of the rest of our lives. With the class of 2022, please stand. And now, take the tassel from the right side and move it over to the left. It is now time for the singing of the alma mater. To the class of 2022, this is the first time you will sing it as members of the newest alumni class. Ladies and gentlemen in the audience, please stand with our graduates for the playing and singing of the Cuyahoga Heights alma mater. Graduates, thank you for your dedication to Cuyahoga Heights High School. And remember that as alumni, you are always welcome back at your high school. To the audience, thank you for your attendance here this afternoon for the 84th commencement of Cuyahoga Heights High School. As we conclude our ceremony, please remain in your seats until all graduates and staff have exited the stadium. Cuyahoga Heights High School Class of 2022, you are dismissed. Thank you.
Thank you.